Dear students, welcome to the science class. In the last class, we started with the new topic, that is nothing but we started with the sound topic. Right? In that topic, we discussed about what is sound. Sound is nothing but it is a source of energy. Why sound is required for the purpose of the communication? In the last class, we discussed for the purpose of the communication in case of animal beings, in case of human beings, we discussed in the last class. Again, we also discuss about how the sound is going to produce. If you remember the last class, sound is going to produce by the what? Sound is going to produce by the vibrations of the objects or the vibrations. Now, what are the vibrations? How does the vibrations are occurring? Vibrations are occurring because of the motion of the objects or material. It is because of the motion of the objects or material due to that vibrations are producing. In the same manner, what are the vibrations? In the last class only we discussed about the what are the vibrations. Vibrations are nothing but it is a to and fro motion of the object or to and fro motion of the sound producing material. Right, if you remember, we are taking the example of the jokali, this jokali. If it is starting position of this jokali is like this, it is going to move in this direction, again coming back to this direction, again going to this direction, again going to come back in this direction. This is nothing but the to and fro motion. In the same manner, vibrations are going to produced by the to and fro motion of the material or of the object or of the surfaces. By those vibrations, the sound is going to be produced. In the last class, we discussed those things. In the same manner, these things are known as oscillations. The vibration, that is nothing but to and fro motion of the objects or to and fro motion of the material, is nothing but oscillation. Right? One oscillation is nothing but one oscillation is from this point to moving to this point, going to this point and coming back to this starting point only. So that is one, this one is one complete oscillation. If we take the round of the jokalis, how we are going to count the rounds of the jokalis? We are going to count the round of the jokali. If that jokali moves in the straight direction, go back and coming to the starting position only, then it is known as one round. In the same manner, in this case, one oscillation is equal to what? One to and fro motion, one complete to and fro motion. So what are the to and fro motion? Those are nothing but the vibrations. What are the vibrations? Vibrations are nothing but it is the cause for the production of the sound. Those are the cause for the production of the sound. So that sound can be produced by the vibrations. If you take any example, those sounds are going to be produced by the vibration. So that in today's class, we are going to discuss about some examples of the how does sound is going to produce, as well as we are going to discuss about the sound production in human beings. How the human beings are going to produce, in the same manner how the animals are going to produce, in the same manner of that human beings, they are also going to produce the sound. So that we are going to take the examples. Like first example for the production of the sound, if you take in the activity, if you seen the activity which is given in your textbook, well, first activity is nothing but a stretch rubber band when plucked vibrates and produces sound. When stretched rubber band, right, a stretched rubber band, when you pluck it, it is going to produce the sound. If you take the stretched rubber band, we are going to stretch that rubber band and we are going to pluck it. When you pluck that rubber band, the rubber band is going to vibrate, starts to vibrate. It is going to vibrate. When it vibrates, it is going to produce what? It is going to produce sound. Why the sound production is happened there? Because of the vibrations of the rubber band. Initially, the rubber band is going to produce sound. It is producing the sound there. No, it is not producing the sound at the initial point. But when you pluck it, when the vibration starts, the rubber band is going to produce the what? It is going to produce sound. So that sound is produced by what? Vibrations of the rubber band. If you take the second example, in the music room of your school, you hear the sounds made by musical instruments like flute, tabla, harmonium, guitar, etc. If you go to your school, in the musical room of your school, there will be n number of musical instruments. All the musical instruments are going to produce different type of sounds. How they are going to produce different type of sounds? How actually they are going to produce the sounds? If you take the example of tabla, when you check the tabla, the upper membrane of that tabla, if you take that tabla like this, if you take the tabla like this, This upper membrane of the tabla is vibrating because of this vibration. When we hit that tabla by our head, because of this vibration, the tabla is going to produce what? It is going to produce sound. In the same manner, when you take the drum, when you take the drum, which is used for the purpose of the Independence and Republic Day, as well as the purpose for the producing the sound, for producing the music, for the high pitch music. So that when you take that drum also, when you hit the upper membrane of the drum, what happens to upper membrane of the drum? The upper membrane of the drum starts to vibrate. It is continuously going to be vibrate. When it starts to vibrate, then only the sound is going to be produced. Then only the sound is going to be produced. Here in this case, why the sound is producing? When a motion of an object, material, that is nothing but we are going to give the motion to the what? The membrane of the drum. When you give the motion to the membrane, when you apply the force on that membrane, the membrane starts to vibrate. That is nothing but it is going to do to and fro motion. When it starts to vibrate, it is going to give what? It is going to produce the sound. So that in this case, if you take the flute again, if you take the tabla, tabla, in that tabla, the upper membrane, the membrane which is going to produce the sound. When you take the guitar also, when you take the guitar, when you starts to play it, what we are going to do? There is a string will be present on that guitar. A string is going to be present on the guitar. So that when we move that string with our hands or with our fingers, what will happen? The string which is present on that guitar starts to move to and fro motion. It starts to do to and fro motion. That is nothing but it is going to do the vibration. It is going to produce the vibrations. When it starts to produce the vibration, what will happen? There will be the production of the sound. That is nothing but in the form of the music in case of guitar. If we take the example of the flute also, what we are doing in the flute? We are blowing the air inside the flute. We are blowing air inside the flute. Because of that air, because of the vibrations of the air molecules which are present in that flute, the vibrations of the air molecule which are present in the flute is going to produce the sound. So that sound is because of the vibrations of the particles which are present in that material or object. So that this is the second example. They are given in the form of activity so that you can do those activities, or you can else like this, you can analyze those things for the purpose of the understanding of the production of the sound. In the same manner, if you take a spoon, when a spoon is beaten on the plate, same example of the estate is also, when you go to the home, when you become hungry, what we'll do? We are going to take the plate, by accidentally we are going to throw that plate on the ground. What will happen? There will be the contact between the ground as well as plate. Because of that, there will be the production of the sound due to the vibrations which is produced in the plate. So that here in this case also we are going to say that it is due to the vibrations also. In the same manner, in a scientific way, we have a tuning fork. This is all general example. To check the production of the sound, to analyze this production of the sound in scientific way, in the scientific materials, in the labs, we have a tuning fork. To check that the sound is produced by the vibrations only, so that we are going to use the tuning fork. That tuning fork is nothing but it looks like this. The tuning fork look like this. Right, this is the handler. By this we are going to see those things, vibrations. So that to analyze, to understand the sound is going to produce by the vibrations only, we have a tuning fork, scientific equipment, right? That scientific equipment, when you hold by this end, when you pluck it, or when you put on, or when you strike that tuning fork on a table or on a bench, what will happen? This upper portion of that tuning fork, this upper portion of the tuning fork starts to move in the to and fro motion. It starts to do motion, that is nothing but it is going to do like this. It is going to vibrate like this. When you check that tuning fork nearer to our ear, when you see that this tuning fork is producing the sound. Why it is producing the sound? Because of the vibrations which are produced in this tuning fork. How the vibrations are produced in this tuning fork? When we crash it, when you hit this tuning fork on a table, then only it is going to produce vibration. Because of those vibrations, it is producing the sound. Because of this vibration, it is producing the sound. In this way, what you have to do? We have to make an activity. We have to make a table. You have to make a table as a homework, so that at least 10 to 15 examples should be there. And in those examples, विच इज द वाइब्रेटिंग बॉडी, हाउ इट इज प्रोड्यूसिंग द साउंड, यू शुड राइट राइट इन दोज एग्जाम्पल्स. यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. यू कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स लाइक ड्रम, लाइक फ्लूट, लाइक सितार, राइट सितार और लाइक एकतारा. एकतारा विच इज यूज इन द एशियन टाइम्स बाई द फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द म्यूजिक. सो दैट वी कैन टेक दोज एग्जाम्पल्स इन हाउ दोज म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर प्रोड्यूसिंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ साउंड ऑन विच फैक्टर्स. इफ यू टेक द ड्रम हियर, इन द ड्रम the sound is produced by the vibrations in the what membrane. So in that manner you should make a table so that in which case in those cases how the sound is going to be produced. In same manner if you take the example of the ektara, in the ektara the music or the sound is produced by the strings which are present on that ektara, so that when you vibrate that string it starts to give or it starts to produce the sound, right? It is all about the production of the sound. In the same manner, what if we take an example, I'm going to take 6 to 8 bowls or glasses, 1 2 3 4 5 6, let it be 6 only. I'm going to put water up to this point in this first glass, second point up to this point, third glass up to this point, fourth up to this point, fifth up to this point, sixth fully, right? And I added water here in the first glass, second glass, third glass, fourth, fifth and sixth glass. The amount of water in each glass is different. I am going to take a spoon, I am going to hit each glass simultaneously. What will happen? When I hit this glass, it is going to produce different sound. When I hit this glass, it is going to give different sound. When I hit this glass, it is going to produce different sound. When I hit this glass, it is going to produce different sound. When I hit this glass, it is going to produce different sound. When I hit this glass, it is going to produce different sound. So that when we hit each glass having the same size of the glass is same, shape of the glass is also same, the application of the force on those glass is also same. But when you check, all the glasses are producing different sounds because of the content of the water. It has less content, less quantity of water, but we compare to this. Because of this, when you hit those glasses, it is producing different sounds. Why it is so? If I hit this glass, it is producing different sound. If I hit this glass, it is producing different sound. I am applying the same force only. The material of the glass is same only, the size and shape of the glass same only, but it is producing different sound. What is making to produce it different sounds? The amount of water which is present in each glass. The quantity of water which is present in each glass is making these glass to produce different type of sounds. So that by this example, by this activity, we can say that sound is produced by not only by the material, it is produced by the whole body. It is produced by the vibrations of the whole body, not only of the vibrations of the material. If you check this, it is also glass. If I hit that glass, all the glasses should produce same amount of sound, same quality of sound. But when you hit the glasses with spoon, all the glasses are producing different types of sound. So that we can say that it is because of the vibrations of the particle, or it is because of the vibrations of the whole thing which is making the sound to produce in different manner. In this glass, water quantity is less, so that it is going to produce different sound, the sound will be maximum. In this, the water quantity is less, so that it is the sound will be comparatively less compared to this thing, so that they are going to produce different sounds. By this activity, we can say that the sound which is producing is because of the vibrations of the whole body. It is because of the vibrations of the whole body, not only of the container or object. Right? If you take the example of the drum only, when you hit the drum, the membrane is not going to produce all the sound. It is because of the vibrations of the complete drum. It is because of the vibration of the complete drum which is going to produce all the sound which we are going to hear. If you want to check those things, hit the drum there. the membrane is going to vibrate. In the same manner, when you check the all the parts of that membrane, all the parts of that drum, it is also going to produce what? It is also going to produce vibrations. Because of those vibrations, together is going to constitute or produce the sound. So that the sound which is produced by an object is because of the all the body, whole body, not only because of the material of that object. Right, in the same manner, if you take the example of the table, or if you take the example of door, while shutting or opening the door, while shutting the door, we are going to push it. What will happen when you push it? The both are going to come in contact. Because of that, they are going to produce sound. When you hold that door, when you check that door, all the door is vibrating. Why it is vibrating? It is vibrating because of the crash between the both the doors. Because of that crash, because of the vibrations, it is producing sound. How does the sound production comes there? Because of the vibrations of the all the door. In the same manner, if you take the example of the drum also, it is because of the vibrations of the all the drum. Because of that, it is producing sound, not only because of the membrane. A membrane, it comes in the contact with the hand, but because of the vibrations of the membrane, the drum is also going to get vibrated. Because of those vibrations, all the sound is going to get produced. If you take the example of the flute also, when you blow the air inside the flute, fluid starts to vibrate. The air molecules which are present in the fluid starts to vibrate. Not only the molecules which are present at the hole of the fluid, the molecules which are going in this direction, in the direction of the fluid, are also going to vibrate. Because of that vibration, they are going to produce sound. So that in this case, we can say that the sound is produced because of the vibrations of the all the particle or all the material, not only because of this instrument, right? So that here we can write a point here. That point is nothing but the sound which is actually produced. The sound which is actually produced, which is actually produced because of the whole body. Produced, it is because of the. It is because of the vibration of the whole body. It is because of the vibration of the whole body. So that if anyone asks, if in the examination asks, how does the sound is going to produce? It is produced because of the membrane only, or it is produced because of the material only, or else it is because of the whole body. If they ask this question, you have to write, the sound is produced because of the vibration of the whole body, not only because of the vibrations of the upper layer. Right, I hope this is clear about all the thing about the sound production. In the same manner, now we are going to discuss about the sound produced by the human beings. Right, now we are going to discuss about the sound produced by the human beings. Which organ is going to produce this sound? How actually the sound is getting produced in the human beings? Right, this is a general outline. These notes are general outline. We are going to see about how does actually the what happening here in the human body, so that it is producing the sound. Right, to check those things you have to do an activity. Sound produced by the humans, you have to do an activity. That activity doesn't require any material or any object or any equipment. What you have to do? You have to take your finger and you have to put that finger on this point of the neck. If you remember, this is known as the Adam's apple. The bone which is plucking out, coming out here in this side, there you have to put your fingers and you should keep silent. When I say talk, or when I say to loudly say a word, that is nothing but or saregama, like this. When you can say the notes of the saregama also. If I put my finger here and try to tell sa sa re re ga ma pa, when you put the finger here and it starts to talk, when you check here, when you observe those things, when you check those things, what will happen? Here is the vibration is are going to produce. At this point, at the Adam's apple point. When you put our finger or on feet over, put our hand here, when you start to talk or when you start to take any words or any notes of this Saregama or musical notes, when you start to say those words, there will be the vibration. Here will be the vibrations of those skin or those Adam's apple. Because of these vibrations, sound is are going to produce in case of human beings. It is going to produce in case of human beings. So that here at this part, whatever I am telling here, here it is part, here the vibrations are going to produce. Because of these vibrations, sound is getting produced. So that, why the vibrations are produced here only? What is making these vibrations are to produce? So that is nothing but in human, sound is produced because of the vibrations of the voice box or larynx. In case of human beings, here at this neck position, whatever I am telling here at this position, and there is a voice box is present. That is nothing but in other words we can say it as larynx. Because of this voice box which is present at the neck position of a human being, which is producing the sound. This one is producing the sound. If you check here, there is a lot of amount of vibrations. Because of this vibration, how does the vibrations are produced here? They are produced because of the larynx or voice box which is present here. So that the sound is produced in the human beings because of the voice box which is present at the base portion. Right. In the same manner, where it is situated? It is situated in the upper end of the windpipe. If you check those things, here is the windpipe which is connected from the mouth to the nose and it is going to connect it to the lungs. Right, in those windpipe, the upper portion is nothing but this neck portion. The windpipe starts here, the upper portion of the windpipe where the larynx is situated. Here the larynx is situated. Why? Because if you say that we are going to eat by mouth and we are going to take the inhalation, we are going to take breathing by the nose, so that all the things, gaseous particles as well as solid particles, are moving by only one path. But after this path, there is going to be two paths. One pipe is going to carry the food to the stomach. In the another pipe is going to carry the gaseous particles to the lungs. So that carrying gaseous particles to the lungs is nothing but it is known as windpipe. In other words, it is known as trachea. So that on the trachea or that windpipe, at the upper portion of that windpipe, we are going to see larynx. So that larynx is present here. It is the upper portion of what? It is the upper portion of windpipe. Right. So that in those things, there are two stretched membranes called vocal cords attached to the larynx with a narrow slit between them for the passing of air. Right. I am going to discuss this thing in the next class in detail. So that how does those things are making the vibrations? How does those things are producing the sound? We are going to see those things in next class. I am just telling about voice box, how it is actually there. So that in that voice box, there will be the two stretching membranes will be present in that voice box. We are going to see it by diagrammatically in the next class. Here in the voice box, there will be two membranes are situated which are attached to the larynx. Which are attached to the larynx with a narrow slit. That narrow slit is nothing but it has a hole. Right. If those are the vocal cords, these are the two stretched membranes. In those stretched membranes, there will be small gap. There will be small gap, that is nothing but small slit. Why there is a small slit? So that there will be passing of the air. It is present on the upper portion of the windpipe, so that the air should be passed through that windpipe. Because of that, there is a gap in between two stretched membranes. Those two stretched membranes which are attached to the larynx are nothing but those are known as vocal cords. Those vocal cords are going to produce what? They are going to produce the sound. Remember these things. That is nothing but sound is produced in the human being by the larynx, which is present in the upper portion of the windpipe. To that larynx, there will be two stretched membranes are connected. Those two stretched membranes are nothing but what? Those are the vocal cords, and they have a slit in between them. So that muscles attached to the vocal cords, everything, human body has the muscles attached to these vocal cords are कैन मेक द कॉर्ड्स टाइट और लूज आर दे आर गोइंग टू मेक द वोकल कॉर्ड्स टाइट और लूज बिकॉज ऑफ द टाइटनिंग एंड लूजनिंग ऑफ दट वोकल कॉर्ड्स दोज वोकल कॉर्ड्स देर विल बी प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द डिफरेंट साउंड्स इन ह्यूमन बींग्स देर विल बी प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द डिफरेंट साउंड्स इन द ह्यूमन बींग्स बिकॉज ऑफ द टाइटनिंग एंड लूजनिंग ऑफ द वोकल कॉर्ड्स विच इज कनेक्टेड टू द मसल्स ड्यू टू दैट देर विल बी डिफरेंट साउंड इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस सो दैट अप टू दैट पॉइंट अप टू द नेक्स्ट क्लास जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस थिंग्स दैट इज नथिंग बट हाउ डज द साउंड इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस इन ह्यूमन बींग्स इट इज गोइंग टू प्रोड्यूस बाई द वाट लैरिंग्स इन द सेम मैनर इन लैरिंग्स वाट आर देर देर आर वोकल कॉर्ड्स विच आर प्रेजेंट हैविंग ए नैरो स्लिट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट देर विल बी प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द साउंड इन द सेम मैनर द मसल्स विच आर अटैच टू द वोकल कॉर्ड्स is going to make tight or loosening of that vocal cords because of the tightening and loosening of the vocal cords we are able to produce different type of sounds we are able to produce different type of sounds we can make different type of sounds if you remember if you see that I am going to have a loud sound as well as unaudible sound we are going to produce different type of sound it is because of the tightening and loosening of the vocal cords which are attached to the muscles And so that in detail we are going to see in next class up to that point. Remember those things as well as given in the homework that is nothing but we have to make a list 10 to 15 items so that in those items how the sound is going to be produced. It may be musical instruments or it may be human beings or it may be animal beings. You have to take those examples and you have to write how does the sound is producing in those things. So that in the next class we are going to discuss in detail about the sound produced in the human beings how does actually the sound is getting produced in human beings how does actually the function of the vocal cords or vocal cords or larynx is doing so that we are going to produce the sound so that we are going to discuss in the next class up to that point thank you take care stay well stay home